Assalamu alaikum students, I hope you all are doing well. Today we will continue chapter number 5, chemical reactions, and the topic is writing and balancing simple chemical equations. Now, what's a chemical equation? A chemical equation is the representation of a chemical reaction in terms of symbols, formulae, and signs. Now, what are the symbols? Symbols are the shorthand notation for an element. Instead of writing hydrogen, we use its symbol H. For uranium, we use U. For chlorine, we simply write Cl. Similarly, certain compounds are also represented by their formula. Like sodium chloride is represented by NaCl. Water is represented by H2O. Carbon dioxide is represented as CO2. So, just like the elements are represented as symbols, formulae are the representations of the compounds, the chemical reactions are represented by a chemical equation. A chemical equation has two major parts, reactants and products. Reactants are written on the left-hand side, products are written on the right-hand side. Reactants are the substances which take part in a chemical reaction, while the products are the substances which are formed as a result of the reactions. There are certain signs which are used in a chemical equation. Plus sign is used to separate one reactant or product from another. And when it is used on the reactant side, we'll read it as reacts with. Like in photosynthesis, we say that carbon dioxide reacts with water. And when it is used on the product side, we simply read it as and. Like in photosynthesis, sugar and oxygen are produced. Arrow is also used. It is used to separate the reactants from the products. It can be read as yields or produces in an equation. Physical states of elements and compounds are also represented in an equation. S within the brackets indicates that the substance is in the solid state. Similarly, L, G, and AQ indicate that the substance is in the liquid, gaseous, and aqueous state respectively. Sometimes a capital Greek letter delta is written on top of the reaction arrow to show that energy in the form of heat is added to the reaction. Sometimes light energy is added to the reaction. In that case, we simply write light on the top of the arrow. Subscripts and coefficients. A subscript is a small number written to the right of an atom in a formula indicating how many atoms of that element are present in the formula. And a coefficient is a number written in front of a reactant or product that indicates the smallest number of particles of the substance that are involved in the reaction. Here, 3 along with H2 is the coefficient, and the numbers there, 2, 2, and 3, these are the subscript. Now here 2 is the subscript written with N. It indicates that there are 2 atoms of nitrogen in 1 molecule of nitrogen gas. When NH3 is written, the subscript with N is not written, then it means that it is 1. So we say that in NH3 there is 1 atom of nitrogen and 3 atoms of hydrogen. And the coefficient represents the number of molecules or how many particles of that substance are reacting. Balancing the chemical equation. In the last lecture, we have done that law of conservation of mass states that mass of reactants and mass of product is equal. And if it's not equal, then we'll balance a chemical equation. Now, balanced chemical equation is the chemical equation in which the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the equation are equal, and such an equation is in accordance with the law of conservation of mass. And if an equation is not balanced, that is the equation in which the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the equation, that is reactant and product side, is not equal, then it is called as unbalanced equation or skeleton equation. As you can see through the examples, that in this example, hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide to form sodium chloride and water. All the atoms of all the elements are equal on the reactant side and the product side. So this equation is balanced. But here, When H2 reacts with Cl2 to form HCl, there are two atoms of hydrogen and chlorine on reactant side, but there are only one atom of hydrogen and chlorine on the product side. So such an equation is an unbalanced equation, and we'll balance it to make it according to law of conservation of mass. Now there are certain rules for balancing a chemical equation when we are trying a method which is called as trial and error method. According to this method, trial and error process of adjusting coefficients before symbols or formula is continued till the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the equation becomes equal. So first rule is that we'll write the unbalanced equation, then we'll count the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the arrow, then we'll multiply the symbol or formula with suitable integer on that side of the equation where the number of atoms of a particular element is less. And in this way, we will repeat the process for all the elements one by one. Now there are two tips basically, that we'll start multiply always with relatively small numbers, and we'll balance the diatomic molecules like H2, N2, O2, Cl2 at the end. Now to elaborate this method, we'll take different examples. First example is Mg reacts with O2 to form MgO. Step 1 is check the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the equation. You can see that on the left hand side there is one magnesium atom, on the product side there is also one magnesium atom. But number of oxygen atom on the reactant side is 2, whereas the number of oxygen atom on the product side is 1. So it is quite clear that oxygen is unbalanced. We'll balance it by inserting a coefficient 2 in front of Mg on the right hand side. Now when in MgO, when we have put the coefficient 2 here, what has happened, that the number of magnesium atom is now 2. So we'll balance it again by multiplying the coefficient 2 with Mg on the left hand side. Now you can see that the equation is now balanced. There are two atoms of magnesium reacting with two atoms of oxygen, and here also magnesium and oxygen have two atoms. There is one important point, that you are not allowed to change a subscript during balancing of equation. You can only change coefficients. Reason? Because if you will change the subscript, it means that the chemical composition of a substance will change. Like H2O is a different compound than H2O2. CO is a different compound than CO2. So we cannot change the subscript. We can only change the coefficients. Secondly, in order to balance a particular atom, you can never put a coefficient middle of the formula. No matter if the number of atoms of the other element will change, but we will always put the coefficient in front of the complete formula. Now, next example is Fe plus Cl2 gives rise to FeCl3. First of all, count the number of atoms of each element on both sides of the equation. Here, Fe atoms are balanced here, but chlorine, here is 2 and here is 3. Now what can you do? That simply we'll multiply here chlorine with 2, means 2FeCl3, and this chlorine by 3. So we'll put a coefficient 3 here. So what will be the equation? Like this. Now you can see that 3 into 2, 6 chlorine atoms, and 2 into 3, 6 chlorine atoms. Now the iron is here, the number of atoms of Fe are 2, where here is only one atom of Fe. So to balance the number of Fe atoms, we need to put a coefficient 2. Now you can see that Fe, 2 atoms, here chlorine, 6 atoms, and here also there are 6 atoms of chlorine. So the equation is balanced. Third example is H2S plus SO2 gives rise to H2O and S. Again, count the number of atoms. Hydrogen atoms are 2 on the both sides of the equation. Oxygen atoms are 2 here, and here it's only 1. Sulfur atoms are 2 on the reactant side, 1 on the product side. So first of all, we'll start to balance the number of oxygen atom. How? By multiplying here oxygen with 2. So we'll put a coefficient 2 in front of water. like this. Now what has happened here, that by putting a coefficient, the number of hydrogen atom is changed. Here the 4 hydrogen atoms are present and here only 2 hydrogen atoms are present. So what we'll do in the next step, that we will simply multiply H2S with coefficient 2 like this. Now you may see that here there are 4 hydrogen atoms and on the product side there are also 4 hydrogen atoms. There are 2 oxygen atoms, there are 2 oxygen atoms, but sulfur is not balanced. Now count the total number of sulfur atoms, 2 in H2S and 1 in S. So what we will do, that we'll put a coefficient 3 in front of S. Now you may check that all the atoms are balanced now. Next example is Na2CO3 plus HCl gives rise to NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. Again, first of all, we'll count the number of atoms of each element. You may see that sodium atoms are not balanced, and since Na2CO3 is the most complicated formula, we'll start balancing by giving it the coefficient 1. Then, in order to balance sodium atoms, we will put a coefficient 2 in front of NaCl. Now what has happened, that the number of chlorine atom on the product side is 2 and on the reactant side is 1. So what we'll do next, we'll put a coefficient 2 in front of HCl. So what will happen, that now all the atoms of the hydrogen, chlorine, carbon, oxygen and sodium are balanced. Last example is Al plus O2 gives rise to Al2O3. Now first of all, count the number of atoms here. Here there is 1 aluminium atom, on the product side there are 2, and similarly oxygen is also unbalanced. First of all, to balance aluminium, we'll multiply aluminium with 2. When we have multiplied aluminium with 2, then aluminium is balanced, but oxygen is not balanced. On the reactant side, there are 2 atoms of oxygen, and on the product side, there are 3 atoms of oxygen. How can we make 2 into 3? By simply multiplying with 3 by 2. Now, it's a different question, because oxygen atoms are 3 on the product side and 2 on the reactant side. So how can we make 2 equalize to 3? By multiplying with 3 by 2. 2 and 2 will cancel and there will be 3 oxygen atoms here and there will be 3 oxygen atoms here. In order to get rid of the fraction 3 by 2, we'll multiply the whole equation by 2. And then the equation becomes 4Al plus 3O2 gives rise to 2Al2O3. Now you may count that aluminium atoms are 4 on the reactant side and 4 on the product side, and there are 6 oxygen atoms on both sides of the equation. I hope you have understood the balancing of the equation. Now, more you will practice, the better you will gain the concept. Allah Hafiz.